Hello and welcome to this GCSE Foundation Level lesson looking at Best Buys. This is section 10.4. Our Do Now lesson starts off, builds upon our learning on direct proportion, which was section 10.3. Pause the video, think about your working out and have a go at the following. Okay, here are your answers to those. 25 women for A, B, 14 eggs, C, 675 miles, D, you've got 4 fudge bars and 2 polo mints. It would be interesting to think, to ask you whether you did those by drawing out a table, or whether you did them by the unitary method, or whether you used a mixture for different questions. Okay, moving forward. So this lesson, 10.4 Best Buys, again builds on what we've had so far in 10.3 and direct proportion. We're going to be using those ideas. So let's move forward. Bronze, finding the cost of unit per unit of mass. Silver, find the mass per unit cost. And gold, solve problems to using the above to establish the best value. You will end up doing either the bronze approach or the silver approach for each question. And then when you're working through them and answering the question, you're actually achieving gold status. Okay, so move forward. The same type of dinner plate is sold in two different packs. This is a previous exam question. I thought we'd build that in as we go. So you've got a small pack with three plates for £5.25 and a large pack with 12 plates for £21.24. Which is the better value for money? And you must show all you're working out. I would strongly urge you, as it says in yellow there, copy this into your exercise book. Well, we're going to use the unitary method that we did before to work out the cost of one plate in each case. So, in the small pack, the cost of one plate will be £5.25 divided by 3, because there are 3 plates, which is £1.75. In the large pack, the cost of one plate will be £21.24 divided by 12, which is £1.77. So which is better value? Well, personally, I would prefer to pay less money per plate rather than more. So the small pack is better value as it is cheaper for one plate. Final tip, make sure you go back and answer the question. As an experienced GCSE exam marker that I am, we often see students arrive at the £1.75 and the £1.77, but they lose the final mark because they fail to answer the question. Don't let that be you. Next slide. We have another example. Again, this is an exam question. A supermarket sells baked beans in two different size cans, 215 grams for 40p and 395 grams for 74p. It's the same question. Which size is the best value for money? And you must show all you're working out. So just to highlight there, if you just put the correct answer, whether it's the smaller or the bigger, with no working out, in your answer is technically correct, but you score 0 marks because there's no working out. So copy the example into your book, and here we go. This time, we're going to work out the number of grams per penny. I always do it that way round because it's the bigger number divided by the smaller number. I don't get lots of 0-point decimals, which can be confusing to go with. So here, I work out the number of grams for 1 pence on the small tin by doing 215 divided by 40, which is 5.375 grams for 1 pence. That means every penny I spend in the small tin gets me 5.375 grams of baked beans. I do the same type of calculation for the large tin. So the number of grams for 1 pence there is 395 divided by 74, which is 5.337, and there's a long, long decimal. This time, I would rather have more grams for 1 pence. So the small pack is better value because you get more grams for 1 pence. Often in life, it's the bigger tin or the bigger that's the better value, but you must work them out. And in these two examples we've looked at, it's the smaller one. Moving on to the next slide. Again, this is another exam question. And I'm going to show you two different ways of answering this question. So, this time, we've got a small can containing 4 litres of cooking oil costing £2.20, and a large can containing 6 litres of cooking oil costing £3.24. The same question, which size of can gives the better value for money? And again, stress, you must show all your working. So, we can approach it in the way as before. This time we can work out the cost of 1 litre, the cost per litre. So for the small one, we've got £2.20 divided by 4, which is 55p. And for the large one, we've got £3.24 divided by 6, which is 54p. Which one gives the better value? Well, I want the cost per litre of cooking oil to be as little as possible to make the best value. So therefore, the large pack is better value. It is cheaper per litre. We're going to look at this question again on the next slide, a slightly different way that you might use. So, we've got 4 litres and we've got 6 litres. To help us compare them, what we could do is we could find the cost of basically the lowest common multiple of 4 and 6, which is 12. So here we can find the cost of 12 litres using each way. So 12 litres from the small one, well, the small one's 4 litres, and we want 12 litres, so we know that 4 times 3 makes 12, so we take our cost of £2.20 and we multiply it by 3. So 12 litres using the small cans would cost us £6.60. We do a similar approach for the large one. The large one is 6 litres. We know that 6 times 2 makes 12 litres. So we take our cost of £3.24 and multiply it by 2 and get £6.48. So using the small cans, it's costing us £6.60. Using the large cans, it's costing us £6.48. So again, we know the larger pack is better value as it's cheaper for 12 litres. Okay, make sure you move on. So there are 4 things that I think when you're working through these questions that you need to be thinking about. What calculation are you going to do before you actually begin answering the question? Perform the same type of calculation in each case. So if you're dividing the grams by the pennies, do that for both of them. Or if you're dividing the cost by the litres, do it for both of them. And you might need to change some units on some occasions as well. One of them might be in grams and the other one might be in kilograms, so you need to put them into the same units like we did at the beginning of our ratio work before you do your calculations. Third thing, we might have to find the cost of the same amount of each one, like we found the cost of 12 litres in both cases with the last example. And finally, write down what you're working out and show full working out. That's the only way to get all the marks. Okay, so here's another example. Have a read through it. See if you can follow it through. Pause the video while you do that. Then move to the next slide, which is where we're comparing things. Here's a third example. Exercise example 15, we've got fish fingers, £4.95 for 36, or £3.40 for 24. They've decided here that you can do this by saying, what's the cost of 12 fish fingers, rather than finding the cost of one fish finger. That finding the cost of one fish finger for in each case would be perfectly correct, perfectly adequate to help you get all the marks in the exam question. It's just showing you don't always have to go back to 1. 12, of course, is the highest common factor of 24 and 36, which is why they've chosen to find the cost of 12 fish fingers. Okay, moving on. Example 16. Which of these is better value? You've got your 2 pots of yogurts. You might want to pause the video and have a go at this. Okay, so moving forward, I've done this on the right-hand side. We work out the cost of 1 yogurt in each case. So in the small pack, It's going to be £1.20 divided by 5, which is 24p. And in the 6 pack of fruit yogurts, we're going to do £1.45 divided by 6, which is 0.241666666 recurring. It would be 24 pence if we rounded it to the nearest penny, but actually you can see that the cost of one yogurt in the large pack is slightly more than in the smaller pack, the pack of 5. So the small pack is slightly better value for money. If in an exam you'd put that they were basically the same cost because they were basically 24 pence each per yogurt, that would be perfectly acceptable. Okay, so just a reminder, the 4 things. Choose your method carefully before you begin answering the question. Remember, you need to perform the same type of calculation for each type when you're comparing. Or you could find the cost of the same amount of something in each case. And the most important thing, think about and write down what you're doing, then put your calculation down, and then your answer. And finally, of course, don't forget to answer the question at the end. So, here's exercise 10F, questions 1 to 3. Pause the video while you work through those. And here are your answers for questions 1 to 3. I hope you got them all correct. Make sure you check that you have shown your working out. Question 2, you could have done them a slightly different way around, but still ended up hopefully with the same answer of which one's better value for money. Mark your work carefully before moving on. It's question 4. This time you've got 3 bottle sizes to compare. So when it says for part B, which is best value for money, you'll need to do 3 calculations before you make your comparison. Pause the video while you do that. Here is your answer for number 4. Again, I just want to stress that the answer is family size for B, but if had that been an exam question and you'd shown no working out, you would definitely score 0 marks. When you've marked it, move forward. Okay, questions 5 to 7. Work through those carefully, please. Pause the video before moving on. Here are answers to number 5 to 7. Again, 5 and 6 just gives you the answer of which one's better. Make sure you've got full working out in the same way that is shown in number 7. Mark them carefully, pause the video before you move on. Question 8, 9 and 10 in the same way, work through them. Make sure you put all your working out down, not just numbers appearing randomly on the page. Answers will follow shortly. Pause the video. Okay, these answers are far better in my opinion because they show you lots and lots of working out, which should help you in your learning. We are getting to the more challenging questions, so don't be put off if you're struggling a little bit. Don't forget, you can always email your class teacher with any problems you've got. Pause the video while you mark. Okay, we've got question 11 and 12, quite complicated questions. They do appear on GCSE foundation level papers, so things could be this awkward and this difficult. Be really careful about setting your working out down to help you pick up all the marks. Pause the video whilst you go through these. Here are your answers to number 11 and 12. Again, pause the video so that you can mark your work. Here's question 13, pulling together lots and lots of things that we've done in our ratio this question. Lots to it, work through it really calmly and really carefully. And again, show you're working out. Here's your answer to 13, quite an intricate question. Would be lots and lots of marks in an exam. Quite a challenge, I think you would have found. Okay, so let's review our learning. We might have used our bronze method, finding the cost per unit mass or unit of volume or unit of length. We might have found the length per unit cost, or the mass per unit cost, or the amount of volume per unit cost, per pound usually, or per penny. And then gold learning, we might have put them all together to establish the best value in lots and lots of situations. And there's some reminders of the type of thing that we have on the right hand side. Just check you understand what everything's about. Okay, so reviewing our learning on chapter 10, we've done the simplifying ratio, using ratios all the way through. And there you go, we have ticks for everything. So for the following lesson, you can expect there to be a review to do, a review to work through, and then the knowledge recall assessment. Use your knowledge booklet to support and help you learn as you prepare for that in the coming lessons. Okay, so well done. Make sure you go back and do any purposeful practice and the relevant Hegarty Maths tasks associated with this learning. Look in the work to complete sheet or folder that was listed when you collected the work. Please make sure you get your Hegarty Maths tasks done, because that's the first place that your class teacher will be looking to see that you're up to date next Monday morning. Okay, well done, and here ends the lesson.